So let me introduce myself. My name is Abhijit Kasurde. I work for Ansible core team. So I have recorded this video for Python Pune and Ansible Pune meetup. So this talk generally talks about latest changes that are happening in Ansible. So you will say why this talk is in Python Pune, because Ansible is written in Python and most of the code base is written in Python. So it is very helpful for those people who are working in Ansible plus Python. So let's hope it helps you a lot. Okay, Bhavin, you can start the video.
Yeah, sure.
Hello everyone. Welcome to this first workshop about Ansible collection in my talk, Ansible Collections Scaling for the Future. So first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Abhijit Kasurde and I'm a senior software engineer in Ansible Content Team. So let's get started. So this is the agenda for today's talk. So first we'll see what changes are happening in Ansible project, why those changes are required. Then we'll see the introduction to collection. Then we'll see what problem does collection solves. Then we'll see how you can use your existing collection, and then laterwards we'll see how you can build your own collection. And in the last we'll see upcoming changes happening in Ansible 2.10 with respect to collections. So first of all, we'll see the stats of Ansible projects. So you can see 17k plus forks are there in Ansible project. So 14k plus stars are given by the community members. Then 4.8k plus contributors are contributing to Ansible project. 46k plus commits are there in Ansible project. And nearly 3500 modules are currently present in Ansible project, which provides out of the box functionality to any automation in your environment. So you can see that number is increasing day by day, and there needs to be a standardized way to deliver this content and manage this content in a proper way. So this is the graph of module being added in the Ansible repo. You can check out more stats about Ansible module in the given link. So let me introduce Ansible collection. So what is Ansible collection? So Ansible collection is nothing but a simplified and consistent content schema. So which provides a standardized way to organize and pack Ansible content. So when I say Ansible content can be playbooks, roles, plugins, modules, documentation, and tests. So there needs to be a way to deliver this content in a atomic way to the customers or the users. So Ansible collection solves this problem. So what are the properties, advantages of Ansible collection? So first of all, it is portable and flexible to deliver. It also provides versioning system. So in upcoming slides, we'll see more about collections. So what is inside the Ansible collection? So if you see on the right hand side, there are playbooks, modules, roles, documentation, tests related to your plugins or modules or your roles. Plus you can have plugins. So plugin can be callback plugin, connection plugins, inventory plugins, like that. And this is combined together with collection, and the metadata is stored inside a file called as galaxy.yaml. So galaxy.yaml is a special file located in Ansible collection which provides the metadata about your collection. So we'll see in detail about this file in upcoming slides. So what is the use of Ansible collection? So it provides a well-defined directory structure to standardize your Ansible content. Then it also provides documentation directory for your Ansible content, which is very similar to Ansible project documentation. There are changes in the Ansible Galaxy command which allows you to create your own collection, install them and build them. We'll see in upcoming slides that how you can create your own collection. So let's get ahead. So this is the directory structure of Ansible collection. So first directory you will see over here is docs directory. So this directory contains a local documentation about your collection. So you can put different collection related documentation in this directory. Then there is a file called as galaxy.yaml, which is a metadata about your collection. So it contains version, the namespaces, then various details, licensing, then various details related to build, etc. Then there is a directory called as playbooks. So this directory contains playbooks with which you can invoke the collection. And we'll see in the demo that how you can use this directory or to run your playbooks from the collection itself. Then there is a very important directory called as plugin. So this directory plugin contains all the plugins plus modules in their own subdirectories. So plugins directory is searched by Ansible Core Engine to find out about the modules present in the Ansible collection. So this plugin directory contains modules, module utils, lookup, then filters and connections. So modules directory contains all the Ansible modules which are available in the Ansible collection. Then module utils directory contains a utility code for the modules to be used by, and the plugins common code that plugins and modules uses. Then you can find lookup plugins in the lookups directory, filters in filter directory, and connection related plugins in connection directory. Then there is a directory called as roles, which is in the same level of plugins and playbook, that is called as roles. So this directory contains existing roles or new roles which are relying on this collection. We'll see the demo how you can create your own roles inside Ansible collection. Then you can, like I said, you can write tests for your collection or the Ansible content inside your collection in this directory and test using your infrastructure. So each Ansible collection is denoted by fully qualified collection name. So you can imagine there are several pieces into naming namespaces in Ansible collection. So first is name of namespace of the collection. So in this example, I am using this collection in my environment, which is called as myorg.mycollection, and it contains a module called as ping. So first, myorg is nothing but a collection namespace. Inside this namespace, I can have n number of collections, and here I have my collection as the name of the collection, and inside this I have a module called as ping. So you can imagine at each level of collection namespaces you can have n number of objects. So you can have n number of namespaces, you can have n number of collections, you can have n number of plugins. So namespacing will solve lot of problems in Ansible namespaces. So we'll see that how it will solve a lot of problems in the upcoming slides. So for now, just imagine fully qualified collection name is a combination of collection namespace, name of the collection, and the name of the module. So what problem does collection solve? So first of all, in the right hand corner you see that this is the current model of Ansible collection before 2.9 or 2.9 release. So we used to have release cycle of 3 to 6 months. Then all the module, people used to create modules, then they used to test them, and then they used to submit their code in Ansible repository, and they used to wait for Ansible release to happen, and then they used to consume the content over here. So this was becoming a big repo inside it. So in 2.10 we deconstructed that model. So now the Ansible core base is consistent of nearly 325 modules and plugins, which is called as Ansible base, which has a slower release cycle, and the community or content which are not available in these repository is segregated into outer circle, which has the faster release cycle. So here you can imagine, you can create test locally, then deliver the content and consume it, execute in days. So this is the change happening in the from 2.9 to 2.10. So, and there are two major changes, like Ansible base is the bare minimum modules and plugins, and it with the introduction of Ansible collections, you can have this release early, release often kind of cycle in your environment. Now we'll see, like I said in the previous slides, there is a fully qualified collection namespaces. So how that come into picture? So first of all, let me introduce a problem called as namespace collision. So in tradition Ansible space, Ansible, we have global flat plugin namespaces. So let's assume that there are two roles, role 1 and role 2. They distribute a module called as my module. Okay. So when I want to use this module, my module, then I have to specify the role, and there is no way with which I can say like what module will run in my playbook. So there was a name collision in this scenario. So with introduction of Ansible collection namespaces, you can identify a particular module with their fully qualified collection namespace. Like in the previous slide I showed you, myorg contains a collection called as my collection, and which contains a module called as ping. So in this scenario, I can have my module inside myorg, my collection, my module. So it will define a particular namespace in this environment, so that I can particularly identify any module in my role or any playbook. So it solves the problem of namespace collision. So with namespace namespacing in collection, you can have your own collection namespace and name. The content in collection is accessed by their namespaces. So like I said, there can be a collection name, collection namespaces, and then my module. So here there is an example of F5 collection. So F5 is the name of the collection, then this is the namespace that it is providing. Then there are two built-in collections available, which holds the legacy and built-in modules and plugins, which are known as Ansible built-in and Ansible legacy. Okay. So how does one use modules in their playbooks? So this is the example. So in the normal scenario, you can use namespaces like this. So you have a playbook over here where you define the hosts, then you have a task. In that task, you can use a fully qualified namespace of your module, like my namespace, my collection, and the name of the module. or if you want to use Ansible built-in, then you can use like ansible.builtin.ping. So this will invoke the by default ping module from the Ansible core repo. Or if you want to use other namespaces or core related modules, then you can say ansible.legacy.ping. Or if your module has a unique name, then you can just simply say that name over here, like in the case of ping. This will still work, but Ansible core engine will find this module namespaces in ansible.legacy first and then in built-in. Yeah, so let's assume that you have multiple collections in your playbook, then how you can use those things. So there is a new keyword called as collection in your playbook. So you just, after host, you can specify collections and what collections that your playbook is using. You can specify these, specify them as a list in this collection, and then simply you can start using them. So the order of finding out the modules in this collection is by this same order. So here my module, if my let's assume that my module is available in other namespaces dot other collection, then it will first find out whether it is available in Ansible built-in, whether it is available in Ansible my name, my namespace or my collection, or it is available in other namespace or other collection. So it will go stepwise in this specified order. Or if you don't want to have this kind of searching mechanism, then you can just simply say others namespace dot other collection dot my module, and it will be fully qualified name, and it will also work with this collection keyword. Yeah, so there is another problem of sharing the code between your plugins and your modules. So if you imagine, if you have like common code between your plugins and modules, then in the roles there is no facility to share this code among your plugins and modules. So you have to write the same code in two different locations while using the role. But with the introduction of collection, you can put the common code into module util directory, and both plugins and modules can use that same code. So you don't have to repeat yourself over there. So like in this image, you can see that each plugin is having its own code, and module util is only used by the modules. But in case of collection, there is a standard one directory called as plugins, and inside that everything is available, and module utils are shared by every plugins available in this plugin directory, like action plugins, connection plugin, filter plugins, and modules use the same module util code, and you don't have to repeat anything over here. So Ansible collection solves this problem of code sharing as well. So how this code sharing works? So this is one example of Ansible collection. This is a Cisco iOS collection. So cisco.ios, you can find this link over here if you want to check out this code. So inside modulator directory, there is a code. So you can just say Ansible collection dot ansible dot net common, and you can use the same code in your directory, in your collection. So this can be written in modules as well and in your plugins as well. Yeah, now we will see how you can use an existing collection. So like I said, there are changes in Ansible Galaxy command. You have used Ansible collection Galaxy command like to in order to install roles or anything like that. So over here you will see that Ansible Galaxy command is modified in a way like this. So if you want to install Ansible collection, you will see you will say Ansible Galaxy space collection space install and the namespace plus the collection name. So it will search the Galaxy itself and it will bring download the content which is submitted by collection owner, and it will copy it in your this directory path. So by default Ansible collections are located in this directory path. So in home directory there is a directory called as .ansible/collection/ansible-collections. So downloaded content will be located over here. You can also specify your own collection path. So this this can be very helpful while you are developing your own content using collections. So the Git repository and the collection path will be same, and you can easily test the collection with the custom path. Now you can use this collection like this. So either you can use fully qualified name, or you can just use the collection keyword and then specify the name of the module. So first is the namespace, then the collection name and the module name. So in this case, FI network is the namespace, FI modules is the collection name, and big IP or device info is the module name. Okay. So this is how the playbook will look like. If I want to use big IP device info from FI networks, which is available in FI collection, then I will be using like this. So in the task, I will just simply specify this thing, and the everything rest will be as it is. There is no other change in your playbook apart from this. Either you can use collection keyword in the top, or you can use the fully qualified collection name like this in this example. Now we'll see how you can create your own collection. So I have created one demo for you. I will be submitting this code in GitHub, so you can check out this code and you can experiment it with this thing. So first of all, like I said, I have exported a environment variable called as Ansible collection path, which will set my Ansible collection path from home.ansible/collection/ansible_collection to this path. So I have a custom directory called as Ansible collection demo slash collection. So I have exported this variable and I am inside this directory. Okay. So you will notice that there is a directory called as collection, and inside this directory there is another directory called as Ansible collection. So this denotes my Ansible collection path. So this is very similar to what we have by default. Instead of having under my home directory, I have just created it under the root directory. Okay. So you can create Ansible collection using Ansible Galaxy command. So right now I am using 2.10. So Ansible collection is supported from 2.9 and onwards. So I'm using Ansible 2.10 here. So we can create Ansible collection. So I have created one collection already called as Acme Power. So Acme is the namespace and Power is the collection name. And we'll see how you can use them in a subsequent demo. So you can create your own collection like this: Ansible Galaxy collection init and the name of the collection and namespace. So let's assume that I want to create XYZ dot my collection. So it will create collection inside this directory. If I do ls, you will notice that one directory has been created for me. So like I said in the previous slide, Ansible Galaxy command will take care of creating a skeleton directory for your collection, which will hold these kind of directory structure. So first of all, it will contain a readme file, which is a bare minimum readme file about your collection. Then you will have docs. Then you will have a direct file called as ansible.galaxy. So this is very important file. This file tells metadata about your collection. So you can see that some of the values are auto-populated by Ansible Galaxy command. So you can see that namespace is defined like XYZ. Then the name of the collection is defined over here. Everything is already documented, so you don't have to take care of that. So it provides you a standardized way of providing the metadata over here. So you can also specify the version. Then you can specify what kind of readme people should read once they download the Ansible content from your Ansible collection. Then it notifies who contributed to this code. Then it provides a short description of your collection. Then licensing used, licensing file, then tags. Tags can be like, if your collection is related to database, you can have tags like Oracle, MySQL, database, relational, something like that. So people will be able to search or index your collection according to their functionality or the use that collection is providing. Then you can also have dependency for your collection. So like for example, if your collection is dependent upon Ansible built-in or Ansible legacy or any other collection which is available in the Galaxy itself, you can specify that dependency over here, and Ansible Galaxy command will make sure that these dependencies are being resolved by Ansible Galaxy collection install command. You can also specify the repository name. Then you can specify the documentation URL so that people can check out your documentation about this collection. You can specify the home page, issues related, and the last one is like build ignore. So while you are building your Ansible collection, you can ignore certain set of files like .get or .pyc files or .retry files or your credentials or secrets that you are holding in your Ansible collection. So galaxy.yaml is nothing but a metadata about your collection. So like I said, there is a very important directory called as plugin. So this directory holds modules, module utils, and the other plugins which are shipped by the Ansible collection. Right now we created this collection from scratch, so that is why there is nothing inside this directory structure, but you can create it on your own as per your requirement. Then you can create roles inside this role directory. So this is the basic information about the collection. Now we'll see how you can use this collection in your environment. So I have already created some example for you. So this is my namespace Acme, and inside this I have a collection called as power. So this is a demo collection. It contains one module inside plugin directory called as modules, and the name of the module is myprint. So this is very generic module which does only printing of hello world from Ansible Acme Power collection. So it prints only one line. It does not take any parameter, it does not take anything, and it does not have any documentation example or return. But this is just for sake of simplicity, because we are trying to understand how collection content is used in the roles or playbooks. So that's why I have created a single module over here. So let's assume that I want to use this collection. So I'll do what? So this is a plain playbook that is using a collection acme.power, and here I am just invoking my print module over here. So this is very plain generic playbook. So I have notified, I have used host as localhost, and I have in the task I have just using acme.power.myprint. So I have already exported environment variable Ansible collection underscore path equal to this path. So that is why it is detecting this path to use for your collection. So if I run Ansible playbook main.yaml, it will read the path variable and it will detect and run the module for me. So if you notice over here, it ran that task, simple task over here, and it is just returning one statement, hello world from Ansible Acme Power Collection, which is written in that my print module. Okay, so if you run it in verbose mode, you will see lot of details about how it is working behind the scene. So here you can, in the verbose log, you can see using module file Ansible collection demo collection Ansible collection Acme Power plugins modules and MyPrint. So this is how it find out about the module and work along this way. So we'll see how you can use this module from the collection itself. So I'll go into this directory structure again. So like I said, there is a roles directory where you can write your own roles. So for the example, I have written one role called as my role, and in this my role I have a simple task called as Acme Power MyPrint, which was available in that previous playbook itself. So here in this roles directory I have only one role called as my roles, and I'll run this playbook from the collection itself using a plain playbook called as playbook.yaml. You don't need to name it as playbook, you can name it as anything. As long as it is available and run findable, you can run it using Ansible command. So here I am just using the legacy syntax of running roles. So I am here just specifying roles and telling Ansible core engine to run my role from here. So and if I run Ansible playbook.yaml with one verbosity, so here you will see that it will give you warning stating that running playbook inside a collection acme.power, which is the current directory structure and which is the correct collection, as and when the collection name changes, this will change, and it is using this role acme.power.myrole, and it is using this module called acme.power.myprint, and it is simply returning this hello world example from this print statement. So you can imagine that you can use different ways to run your namespace Ansible collection from within the roles, using the within the collection using roles, and without using the collection directory. So let's get back to the presentation itself. So you can also build your Ansible collection in order to create a tarball file. So here you can specify this command Ansible Galaxy collection build, and from the inside directory if you run it, it will create your Ansible collection inside a tarball, and you can distribute this and you can install this Ansible collection using command called as Ansible collection, Ansible Galaxy collection install, and the name of the tar file. So it will process the dependencies, and it will also install those dependencies, and it will also install the current given collection. Yeah, this has this we have this is covered. So like I said, this is the example that it will run. Now coming to the last part of this talk, we'll see what are the upcoming Ansible 2.0 release contents. So Ansible 2.10 will be Ansible Community Distribution, or in short form called as ACD. So which will have Ansible Base as a core engine and Ansible Collection as a content. So this content is basically content moved from the Ansible core repository into a logical collection called as Ansible Collection. So which will contain Ansible POSIX, Community General, and some other required collection from the Ansible repository. All playbooks and artifacts that worked in Ansible 2.10 will continue to work without any change in the 2.10. So it is backward compatible, so you don't have to change anything. So everything will work as it was working in 2.9. The only major change you will have to take is like while using the newer Ansible collection content, you have to specify the namespaces. Otherwise, it will try to find it under the Ansible collection namespaces. Ansible base will have routing file that will route everything under the modules and plugins. So for example, like if you don't specify any namespaces and you have installed the collection which is required by your playbook, then Ansible engine will take care of routing your routing. Basically it will find out your modules and plugins for you, and it will just run them as it is. Unless and until there is a namespace collision or something wrong happening with your environment, it will find it seamlessly. Then after any new content is added in post 2.9 release, will be fully it should be fully qualified collection name, and it should be called with the fully qualified collection name within your playbooks or rules, like we did in the last demo. So this is all about the changes that are happening in Ansible 2.10. So thank you for listening this talk. You can find my GitHub ID and IRC ID over here. Thank you. Yeah, thank you everyone. So let me know if you have any questions around collections. So this was very specific to Ansible. In order to perform these guidelines, you need to have basic knowledge about Ansible. Yeah.
Yeah, Vijit, let me share my screen. So in the meantime, you want to talk about migrating from Python 2 to Python 3. So So I can see a few discussions around Python 2 to Python 3 migration there. So that would be great to discuss on live stream as well.
Definitely.
Yeah. So in the meantime, I will try to share my screen.
Yeah, sure. No problem. Yeah. So Python 3 and Python 2 support is already available in Ansible Core Engine. So from January 1st, as we know that 2.7 is deprecated and everybody is migrating to Python 3. So Ansible Core Engine is already supporting Python 3, Python 2 compatible code. So they use six library and they have their own custom compatible code so that you can use that code in your modules. So as long as you are using custom, if you are using built-in modules, you don't need to do anything apart from like testing your code. But if you are using custom modules or custom plugins or third-party modules, third-party plugins, then you need to change that code to migrate it from Python 2 to Python 3. So from the perspective of Core Engine side, Core Engine is all supported as Python 3. It on the other hand, it can support Python 2 on the managed node side. So even if your machine is the one which is being managed by Ansible is in Python 2, so it can manage that machine as well. So it is not required to migrate that machine to Python 3. It just Python 3 support needs to be added into Ansible controller itself and not to the managed nodes. So it can work seamlessly on Python 2 and Python 3. Yeah.
Okay. So I also had a very basic question, you can say. So right now, let's say I'm writing a few playbooks and I have tasks folder and I have all the folder structure required for it.
Correct.
And so how should one go about it when they are sharing it? So let's say I created one playbook, which is basically collection of tasks, and I'm just using basic modules like DNF and all. And let's say it's a workstation setup playbook, and I want to share it with others. So should I go via the route of creating role, or should I just go directly with the collection route?
Yeah. So that is a very good question. So collection are meant to for these purposes only. Means like in order to share the content, make the content owner aware of that content, collection is used for that. So you can use Ansible Galaxy to distribute your content with other community members or the users. So let's assume, we'll take your example itself, that you have written some playbooks to configure your laptop or desktop machine or anything using Ansible. So first of all, you can write a bunch of playbooks, or you can write a role which can take custom user inputs and perform according to that. Like it can take configurations like what kind of desktop environment you want, what kind of packages you want, or something like that. And depending upon this input, the role will perform certain set of actions. So first of all, I'll recommend role is the first way to go. And once you have matured enough, you can move it to the collection. So you can imagine collection is a superset of roles. So roles can deliver modules plus playbooks, but collection can deliver modules, plugins, documentation, tests, and other stuff. So you can imagine collection is a bigger brother of roles itself. So you can build your collection, or you can build your role and submit it to Ansible Galaxy. So Ansible Galaxy is nothing but a content delivery network for Ansible. It is just like PyPy for Ansible. So if you do Ansible Galaxy in a role install and the name of the role, or Ansible Galaxy collection install and the name of the collection, it will download just like pip, just like what we do in pip install, and it will download and you can start using that using Ansible commands itself. Yeah. So you can go to galaxy.ansible.com and you can check out the code over there. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm having some issues with screen share, but I will read out few things which were discussed in the chat.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. You talked about first task comes, then play, then playbook, then role, and then collection.
Yes.
So yeah, and you can imagine collection for Ansible as a pip packaging way for Python.
Yes.
Yeah.
So whatever we have, we have modules for Python. Just like that, we have collection for Ansible.
Right.
Yeah.
There was another question by Vijay. Is this Ansible collection directory structure same as what we follow for Ansible AWX production deployment?
Yes.
Yeah. So you said
the same one. Yeah.
Yeah.
So Ansible, for the people who don't know what is Ansible AWX, Ansible AWX is a web UI for Ansible CLI. So it provides a lot of facilities like logging, group creation, then log retention, project creation, project management, workflow management, like that. So it's an open source project written in Django. So you can also contribute to that project. It's very well written project. So it is just a web UI on top of Ansible. So whatever Ansible does. It is happening in the AWX as well. So it is same for AWX plus Ansible. Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, I will second the opinion about it is a well-written project. I also took references from that a lot of times. Next one was, so Ansible collection solves major problems for Ansible core deployment and for AWX, and we can use it for reference.
Correct.
So yes, that is correct. I guess that's all we had. Let me just check if there are any other questions.
Yeah, there was one connection related to...
You want to explain about that? Basically, explain the question and then talk about it.
Definitely. Yeah. So the question was, Vijay has REST API related API points and how he can automate that using Ansible. So Ansible provides a module called as URI module, which can talk to REST API related things. So you can provide like username, password, headers, body. You can upload the files like using FTP sites or something like that. So URI module is a complete package which can be used to automate your endpoints. So you can imagine, let's assume you have a digital ocean environment and you want to create some floating IPs, or you want to create some droplets, or you want to create some firewall rules or something like that. So DigitalOcean provides you a REST API endpoints. So if you provide required data to these endpoints, it will perform certain set of actions. So you can automate everything related to these APIs using Ansible. So there is a module called as URI module. And the next question was, can we automate put and post requests? So you can do that. So there is another thing in Ansible called as HTTP API connection plugin. So Ansible uses different API connection plugins like SSH, Paramico, then HTTP API. So HTTP API connection plugin can be used to automate REST APIs. So just like Linux machine, we talk to Linux machine using SSH command. We talk to REST endpoints using HTTP API connection plugin. So there are different connection plugins available. You can write your own connection plugin as well, which can talk to different kind of machine. So for example, in Docker environment, if you want to talk to Docker container and you don't have the IP address of that Docker container, you can use Docker connection plugin to directly talk to that container within Ansible. So it will not use SSH or it will not use any network stack. It will just use Docker command or Unix socket file to communicate to the container itself. So you can talk to any Kubernetes pod as well using kubectl command. So there are different connection plugin. So in order to automate REST API, you can use HTTP API connection plugin. Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, that was. Yes.
Yeah.
I hope to know. Yeah, you can always talk to me on Ansible channel. My handle is akasude. If you have any questions, you can just ping me over there, or you can just use the mailing list of Ansible channel or something like that. So there are different ways with which you can communicate with the Ansible community. Yeah.